Hello and welcome back. I want to continue on the Ladybug Tools. We still need to cover a lot of things. We only scratched the surface. Days get warmer, at least here, so it's a good time to actually revisit some of this stuff. And there are also where a lot of questions came up, which I want to discuss. So for one of my videos in the past, which was the Ladybug Tool, the direct sun hour analysis in the la for the latest Ladybug Tools, a question came up if we need the E plus weather data file in order to run that calculation. The quick answer is no, we don't need the E plus weather data because the direct sun hour analysis only needs the location and the elevation, and we can custom create our location. We don't need to have the weather data, and that we'll look into right now. So what we would want to come up with, here's some mistakes, but we'll talk about this. But what we want to come up with is this kind of sun study, which tells us on the surface of the building and the surrounding on how many hours there was a direct sunlight. Direct sunlight means for each of the test points, you have a direct visual connection without any blockage between the test point and the sunlight or the sun. That means direct sun. This study does not take into account any indirect light, for example, the skylight or reflection from a surface. It really only gives you the direct sunlight. It also does not take into account any weather pattern, like clouds or something like that. It is only really just the position of the sunlight and the model. This is very important to understand because there is some confusion between the direct sunlight hour analysis and the radiation study. These are different things. They're fundamentally different. So we need to be very careful with this. But yeah, that's what we want to come up with, and let's jump into that right now. Creating a new file here. And I see these scripts always as preparing the data, solving the data, and visually output the data. Similar to here, it's actually importing data, then data analysis the data, analysis, visualize the data, analyze geometry. It's a different kind of approach, but basically that's how I see it. It's like data preparing, solving, visualizing. And in that case, we would go in here, and I like to start with the solver, with the problem solving portion of the script, because that tells me exactly what I need in order to solve that problem. And I go here in the analyze geometry, and the first one is the Ladybug direct sun hours. And again, for the inputs, so I would go from top to bottom through the inputs, and any input which has an underscore at the front is a mandatory input. Anything with underscore at the front at the end, it's mandatory, but it has a default value already. Anything which has a underscore at the end is an optional input. So what we need is the vectors, and what is meant by vector is basically the vector of the sunlight. And how do we get that? So if you hover over it, it actually tells you exactly what we need to input here. Sun vectors from a ladybug sun path, and we just need to find it now. We could type it in, sun path, ladybug sun path. So actually you can see it here, it's the ladybug sun path. That has a lot of outputs and inputs. Let's concentrate on the outputs. Here we have vectors. This is actually what we need, vectors. And then we need time step. Let's not look at that for now, we don't need that. But we need the geometry. Let's then input the geometry. We get the B-wrap container, can place it in here. And we select all these. You always select what you want to, the surface you want to calculate. That's in here, the geometry. It doesn't necessarily be always the full model. Maybe it's just the ground plane. But then we need to also select the context. I'm not sure why here the underscore is at the end, because we need the context. So I think this is a mistake. I'm not sure, but I think it's a mistake. Any case, we can use all the geometry which we test also as a context. So basically it calculates the self-shading aspect. So we can actually put this into here as well. So the geometry is also the context in that case. But it could be that you have a plot of land within different, like within a city environment, and basically you don't want, you only want to calculate that ground plane, this that one plot, and then the city around or the buildings around that plot are your context. Then you will not put these buildings into the geometry. You would only put them into the context. Hope it's clear. Then the grid size is the resolution of the test. So go in here. There's actually I think a better way. I put here a maximum of 10. That means 10 meter grid, a 10 meter grid. For this small model, we actually can go with 1 meter and probably less. But let's not go too small because otherwise it just takes longer to calculate. You can of course then test smaller grid sizes. So this goes in here, and then we also need a run toggle to turn that on and off. Toggle, boolean toggle, that goes into here. Now this is pretty much done. There's nothing more to do. Of course we can play with the legend parameters, but that you can try on your own, and it's shown in other tutorials already. Now let's check what we need in here. We need the north. That's only if our model is not northern. So if you rotated your model and it's off north, then you need to provide a line or a vector to define what is north. In my case, mine is just placed as it is, so I don't need this. But we need a location. And normally, previously, we got the location from the weather file, and we can do that quickly. So I get this, the E+ file. We can connect this here. We can look for a weather map. Let's copy that toggle here. And we need a panel. That's pretty much it, yes. So then we clicked on here and we went to the weather map. I just choose something here, Madrid. I want to choose on purpose something which is outside of Madrid and not in Madrid. Something more on the mountain. La Paradilla. Paradilla. I hope I pronounce it correctly. Here, that we choose this position. That's our property location, somewhere here. And now we can see, okay, we don't have that. There is no weather file. So the next would be, in that case, here. But let's say we use the Madrid one. Okay, let's say the Madrid one is the closest. And you can see there's a yellow button. There's a yellow circle here. We can click that. Copy, go back to our script, place that in here, and then it ticks a bit and turns gray, and it means we got everything. And then when we look into the location with a panel, we can actually see what's in there. Madrid, latitude 40.41, longitude -3.68, time zone, that's the time zone, is 1, and elevation is 582 meter. So we just need to recreate that for our custom location. So basically, if we don't have this whole component here, what are we gonna do? Well, there is actually a tool. It's called Ladybug Construct Location. So we don't need necessarily the weather file. We can do that very easily here. So at the moment, it has a default value. Let's get this here. Default value. Name is nothing. Latitude is 0, longitude is 0, time zone is 0, elevation is 0. Okay, we can change that, of course. So we can give it a name, La Paradilla. Problem now, we don't see anything here. So what we do, we go into Google Earth, launch Google Earth, and I let you know why I'm using Google Earth. It's because. So let's go here, let's try to find it. Here it is. Okay. Small, nice little village. Okay, for example, let's say our position is here, somewhere here. What can we get out of here? We can specify a name. We don't have to, but that's possible. Can put this in here, then we already see this updated. The name is updated. If we compare it with with the metadata version, then we see also okay, Madrid. Now we can put in the latitude. Of course it doesn't work. Elevation. So in here we can actually, so that's why I choose Google Earth, because I get a bit more information. And what you need to do is, in order to put in the coordinates, you can see the coordinates here on the lower end, and also the elevation. You can see the elevation here. In order to do that correctly, you need to actually change the settings from, if you have here degrees, so if you go into settings, you can actually go into the format and units, and latitude longitude formatting. By default, it's degrees, minutes, and seconds, but you need to put it in degrees, decimal, and minutes. Or decimal, I think. Let's check that, yes. You need to put it on decimal, then this is the format we need for Ladybug. So in that case, that would be 40.55 and 4.24. So if we go back here, we can put in 40.55 as a longitude, latitude, and then longitude would be 4.24. Okay, and then time zone is 0.1, it's the same as Madrid. And then the elevation we can also get from here, 1124. Now it works. By the way, you cannot do this. You cannot run this through the panel and then back into the location. That doesn't work. Directly connect this here. And then if we go further through here, what do we need? Actually, this is also wrong. We need the sun, the hours of the year. This is our period, the time period we want to test. So, and that works again as in the other tutorials. I just need to get my Ladybug analyze period. And at the moment, if I just use what's in here, it's the whole year. So I could test the whole year if I want. But because that will take a while, I will just, here I will put in some numbers. It's easier. By the way, you can actually change the color of these panels if you want. So for different types of data input, you can change it. So let's say 6 for June, start day, today's 12th, start hour, let's say this is 4, and what I'm gonna do is I just copy this in here, end month, I take the same time for the start and the end, and that will give me, so we'll change it later, but I want to show you something important that you really understand it. So we take this as a period, but it's actually just 1 hour. So the output here is just one number representing the hour of that specific time. That's the hour, that's the specific hour of that year. And we put this in here. Now when we run that, so everything is gray, looks good, and now we can run it. And it should be fairly quick. Yes, it's quite quick. And you can see that the maximum is now is 1 hour, and the minimum is 0. Because we only testing 1 hour. So I turn this off because I get annoyed with this bit. And there's another issue is that if this happens where you have something like this, where it's all blue, and it's on the other side, then it means that these objects are not oriented correctly. So you go here and go and flip, and then now it recalculates everything, and now it's correct. So also here. Now it calculated that only that specific hour, and this tells you exactly what that analysis does. It really checks for each of these test points or test cells, the test grid cells, it checks if it gets sunlight or not, direct sunlight. And if I choose a longer period, then it does the same thing, but it just then generates an average. So for example, let's start this here earlier. Let's go, let's say we test the whole day. Eight in the evening, from eight in the evening, from let's say 6 in the morning to 8 in the evening. We need to unlock that again. Takes a bit. It's actually quite quick. Now we can actually see this is 15 hours, so we're testing 15 hours, and for each hour it does the same. It checks, does it get sunlight, yes or no? Does it get sunlight, yes or no? So now we see that actually here the maximum is 15 hours, because that's the time, that's the amount of hours we're testing. So these bits here in yellow, they get 15 hours full sunlight. And then some of these areas, they don't get much, they only get maybe 1 hour. And that can inform a whole program for your project. Or maybe it forces you to change the massing. Because for example, now you could say, actually this area is way too exposed. I need to add some shading to make this a comfortable space. Or maybe you want to make this terrace bigger, because actually this is gets more sunlight in the evening and not during the day, for example. If you have a different project typology, like a mixed use project, for example, where you have a coffee shop and you want to position the coffee shop on the best possible location, then this kind of study can help you a lot. Or if you want to test if an office building needs shading devices on the facade, then this kind of study will help you. We could look at specific examples in another video. Okay, I hope that makes things clear. So you don't need the weather data file. See you next time.